If you're interested in charming embroidery and applique projects, you definitely want to watch today's video because I'm going to be showing you an amazing book that is just so cute. Okay, before we get to that though, if you're not already a subscriber on my YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe now and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. Hi, I'm Kim of Chatterbox Quilts. Today, I'm taking a look at So Illustrated, 35 Charming Fabric and Thread Designs by Minky Kim and Kristen Esser. Now, this is a Stash Books publication. They are a division of C&T Publishing. If you don't know who Minky Kim is, where have you been? Oh my goodness, she has the cutest little designs, and I mean little designs. So she takes fabric, so it's like little appliques, and then she stitches around them with her sewing machine with black thread. So they're really whimsical, very cute. She has all kinds of little projects. I absolutely love her style, and I want to share some of this book with you today. Now, the book itself has all the different designs in the back of the book, and these are iron-on transfers. So you can use them as iron-on transfers, or you could trace the designs if you wanted to. Keeping in mind, if you're tracing them for fusible web, you'll need to reverse them. All right, there are different methods to trace designs onto fabric, and she goes over different ones. I mean, you could use the iron-on ones, of course, but she walks you through how to do that. Or you could use a heat transfer pencil, you could use tracing paper, you could even use a light box to trace them. She goes through all this in the front part of the book, so that's really helpful. Then she has all these different designs with what she calls fabric accents. So that's what I call applique, but they're little tiny pieces of fabric, right? So this is a great book for using scrap fabrics up. If you've got lots of little scraps in your studio, they're gonna work in these projects. So she walks you through the technique of how to take the fabric and get it onto your project and everything. And then she gets into a variety of projects. So one of the first ones that we look at here is called Tea Mat. And again, these are small projects for the most part, so don't take too long to do. But there's the opportunity for a lot of personal embellishment on these, and that's what I really like about the projects. You can see the tea mat here. You've got the little teacups together. Here you've got the macarons that are there, and she's put on here Enjoy. Really cute. And you can see how small they are. They're not very big, right? So again, won't take you long to do. And she has dessert mats. Now these are really cute. You can see the little tiny food on them and the little trim and everything. She likes to use a lot of different, I would say more retro looking fabrics in hers, but you could use any kind of fabric you want as far as color and that. You could make them more modern looking if you want, but they kind of have a really sweet old fashioned appeal, I think. Pin cushions. Who doesn't like pin cushions? And there's a lot of opportunity to make all kinds of fun little pin cushions with the different appliques that come with this book. So here she's got the little sewing machine. I love that. Scissors that are actually embroidered. And then she's got, you know, your coffee cup. She has other stitching. So you could do lots of different things with them. I like how she's got the little hanging loops on them if you want to use them as decorations or have them on your arm, I suppose. If they were elastic, you could do that. But you can see how small they are. They are not large at all. So it does not take much of a scrap to make the base of a little cupcake there or anything, right? But what gives them the charm and the added appeal is the stitching she does afterwards. It makes them more real, I would say. Then she has these notions basket, really cute. And again, there's the opportunity, as you can see, to do a variety of different designs on here, whether it's applique or whether you just want to stitch some of these designs on. You could do that on these. And of course, these are very helpful in your studio. She has a fabric envelope, she calls it. Now this is great for like an iPad. You could fit a smaller iPad in there, or you could use this to put other kinds of information. If you like to carry a little notebook around with you or something like that, that would help to protect it. Very cute as well. So you can see how she does all the little different stitching around these to give them that extra interest. Step-by-step instructions in them, full-size templates as well, of course, which I love to have. I really like this long-handled bag. I like the typewriter on it, love that. And she's got Today is the Day on there on the fabric, but you could put on there anything you wanted, right? So I think this would be great as a little wall hanging, actually. And this house zipper pouch is absolutely adorable. She's put her daughter's name on here so you could personalize this. And it is absolutely just adorable, I think. Here she's fussy cut the fabric out as well. So if you've got fabric that has different motifs in it, this would be a perfect project. And she shows you step by step. You can see how she's got all the photos, making it really easy to follow along. so you can construct it easily yourself without having to think a lot about what goes next, right? Then she has art for your home. So you can see the different wall hangings that she has here, a pillow that she has. Again, look at this one here, it's so cute. And you can see if you took away all the stitching, how it would just look like little bits of fabric. I mean, you could tell what they are, but the stitching is what ties it all together. And of course, the one with her husband and the three kids is just amazing. So here's that hoop art I was telling you about. So you can just put this into an embroidery hoop. This is 10 inch square, actually. And so not very large at all, but you can see the differences here. Here she has drawn it out, getting ready to fill it in. And you can see the little boots are in there to start with, but she shows you how to do all this and give you suggestions as you go through. So here it is. That's how big it's going to be. So again, tiny, tiny pieces of scrap fabric. Doesn't take a lot. And then of course, vignette has the sewing machine in it. And again, all the details on this, you can see are all stitched on. That's what makes that machine look like a real sewing machine, right? Is all the stitching she's done on, because you can see what it looks like before. Quite a difference. It's interesting how much of a difference that stitching does make. I mean, we recognize the shape, but it makes a huge difference when she actually puts the sewing machine stitches into it. Again, perfect for your sewing room, perfect as a gift for one of your sewing friends. And then the family picture we talked about before. Again, you could customize this yourself, change the hair color, two children instead of three, whatever you need to put in there. Very, very cute. So I love this book by Minky Kim. This is great for someone who wants to use up their scrap fabric, who wants to have some little charming wall decorations in their studio or to make as gifts for someone else. I like how they've got the iron-on transfers in the back of this book, or you could trace them. I also like the fact that there's a variety of different projects in here. So it's not just, you know, quilts, or it's not just wall hangs. You've got a variety of different projects in here. And who wouldn't adore that little house pouch there? So, so cute. So if you are into cute like I am, you want to pick up So Illustrated by Minky Kim and Kristen Esser. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. If you're interested in more quilt information, check out my online membership. It's called The Quilter's Way, and you can find it at thequiltersway.com.